this little documentary is a good way to help spread the word, to build the movement. But Ian Dowling did so much hard work with others to bring the next few days of talks together. We were talking about how many of us who work on this issue, thousands around the country, and so many of you have been a part of that movement, but how our movement is not disconnected to all these other struggles for justice and peace and equality in our country and our world. And we were thinking it would really be important if you could just really briefly just let us know sort of issues that you might be working on, that, you know, expressing this solidarity, this work for peace and justice. I know a lot of good friends over the last, just recently, have been gathering in Washington over the Guantanamo Bay issue. Friends who gather down in Georgia, there's, you know, for the vigil, a very important workshop that bring together many to address the issue of those drones in Afghanistan. There's environmental issues and other issues, Palestine, but we'd be very interested if you could just let us know kind of the issue that you've been working on also, if anyone would like to just mention that. Please.
The tar sands pipeline.
Okay, great.
I'm Madeline Hoffman, Director of New Jersey Peace Action, and we've been involved in all the issues you mentioned, but also there's a petition on the table in the back to try to stop any war against Iran before it begins, because they're really ratcheting up the rhetoric yet again, and we want to try to prevent another Iraq from happening there, or worse. So that's right on. And the petitions are going to be delivered on February 2nd, Groundhog Day. So we have 2 weeks to gather signatures, and they're in the back there.
Yeah, be sure. There's a table filled with very important resources and out in the back of the church. Please.
I went there. I went to Pax Christi, which is the Catholic peace movement. But we had one success this year, but it's getting the death penalty overthrown in New Jersey.
Yeah.
Please.
I work for immigration reform, and we're looking for more volunteers to visit immigrants who have, many of whom have left Colombia, Haiti, El Salvador, Mexico, any number of places, and Africa, and are in Hudson County Jail, Essex County Jail, Delaney Hall, Elizabeth Detention Center, Bergen County Jail. See me if you'd like to volunteer to visit them.
With Viva International at the UN, we work on human trafficking, illegal, illicit commerce of weapons, sustainable development, quite an array of issues.
Thank you.
I volunteer for Peace Alliance, which is campaign to create United States Department of Peace. And we support the legislation to decrease the violence in United States and hope that one day we will have the Department of Peace.
Yeah, I'm a once married Catholic priest, and I continue in my ministry. The reason I mention it is because I worked in Panama in one of the first base communities in San Miguelito. And that was when the School of the Americas was still in Panama. And I wish we had realized how evil it was then. But at the moment, I've been involved in many things, but I want to mention two. One is the issue of climate change, which I think is connected with everything else, which often gets just sort of put as a footnote. I wish it were. The other thing is I'm part of a group called Occupy Faith, which is an interfaith clergy group that is working down on Wall Street with the occupiers. And I believe that occupation movement is one of the great prophetic outbreaks of our times. And It's extraordinary. I just marvel at it every time I get to hear the wisdom of these young people. And I recommend it to your everybody's support.
I'm Wendy McNeil, and I'm working on something local in Montclair, New Jersey, and that's for affordable housing in Montclair. And on Tuesday, the town council is having a meeting, and those who support affordable housing to keep Montclair diverse economically, you should come out and speak in favor of affordable housing.
I'm Larry Leducky. I have two different hats with Amnesty International. One is as the legislative coordinator for New Jersey, so I work on things like closing Guantanamo and also things like supporting the DREAM Act for immigrants. Yeah. My other hat is as the country specialist for El Salvador. One of the things that I've been working on there has been violence against anti-mining activists in Cabañas, as well as the violence against journalists who've tried to investigate what's going on there, the violence against them. And Amnesty hasn't put out an official statement here on this, so don't take my words about what I'm about to say as Amnesty's words, but earlier this week, President Funes made some very pretty words, said some very pretty words at El Mozote about ending impunity in El Salvador. But that's greatly against the actions that he's taken in naming a graduate of the SOA and a former member of the Belloso Battalion, one of the rapid reaction battalions like the Atmacatan Battalion that committed the massacre of El Mozote, as the new Minister of Public Security and Justice in charge of the civilian police force. And if I'm not mistaken, El Salvador still has the training center for the police of the Americas. So having this guy in charge of the police down there is a threat to the whole region.
I work just upstairs, and we do corporate responsibility work. So there's lots of things that we do. And just too quickly that I'll mention, is we support a lot of the work being done with corporations on ending child labor, specifically in the cocoa industry. And then one of the other things we've begun working on is excessive speculation and how betting on the price of food has thrown almost a million more people since 2007 into hunger issues.
Give a presentation. He's with the Israeli Committee Against Housing Demolition, ICAHD, which is very beneficial.
I think that the work that the School of the Americas Watch is doing is very, very crucial, obviously. But I think there's an interconnection with all these various issues. When you look at them, you see that there's a similarity. As one of human rights issues, and also there's an empire building problem we have worldwide right now. We've got the intervention of the United States and the European nations in situations all over the world, the use of these drones all over, where they specifically target individuals and they can take these individuals out with the drones. And I think that all these connections are, they really are part of the same problem. And that we live in a different type of world today. It's a unipolar world, and the United States and the Western European countries, so-called democracies, are imposing their will on nations all over the world, at the same time that democracy in our own country is being whittled away little by little. It's a very serious problem.
Anne and I were This is going to be a very diverse group, but this is truly amazing. This is really solidarity at its finest. And I know for me personally, when we gather down at the vigil, we have all these workshops. We take over the convention center. And once again, we see such diversity. We see this interconnectedness and how we all need each other in the struggle. That no one movement or one project or something that we're doing is more important or than the other. We all need each other. And like Bishop Oscar Romero reminded us before he was assassinated, in that struggle for justice and solidarity, we can all do something, and we can do it very well. But I and Ann, Joe and others, we'd be happy, you know, to respond to questions that you might have about the movement. I'm happy to say, as I travel and talk daily to all these other struggles for justice and peace and equality in our country and our world. And we were thinking it would really be important if you could just really briefly just let us know, so to bring the next few days of talks together. We were talking about how many of us who work on this issue, thousands around the country, and so many of you have been a part of that movement, but how our movement is not disconnected from issues that you might be working on, that, you know, expressing this solidarity, this work for peace and justice. I know a lot of good friends over the last, just recently, have been gathering in Washington over the Guantanamo Bay issue. Friends who gather down in Georgia, this is, you know, for the vigil, a very important workshop that bring together many to address the issue of those drones in Afghanistan. Others, environmental issues and other issues, Palestine, but it would be very this little documentary is a good way to help spread the word, to build the movement. But Ann Dowling did so much hard work with others.